Over the last few years, the market has seen a lot of interest in AR pistols. Well, what an AR pistol is basically it's a short-barreled rifle with a stock removed. So that counters it as a pistol. What that enables you to do is to get around a lot of the laws, have it either get a gun trust or a Class 3 license, and get approval of your local law enforcement officials. So the pistol has permitted everybody to be able to have a short-barreled rifle without having to go through that. So the pistol that we're looking at is the SIG 516 pistol. The first thing we're going to notice on the back is what's called the SIG brace. And this is not a stock. What this actually does is it permits a stabilization brace. So when the rifle is or pistol is fired, this permits the pistol from not going back and forth. So it's more of a stabilization brace. However, there's been a lot of controversy surrounding this, so that's beyond the scope of this evaluation of the rifle. So from here, we're going to look at the barrel itself. The barrel is actually a 7.5-inch cold hammer forge barrel, one turn and 7-inch twist. It will stabilize anything that's out there in the market right now. We have a standard flash suppressor. You notice we have an ambidextrous, very high-profile safety. This is the SIG standard pistol grip. We flip it over. The SIG 516 has an ambidextrous magazine release, and the actual bolt catch has been modified quite a bit itself, so it's easier to grasp. Also, on the rear of the receiver, we have two quick detach points for sling swivel attachments. We have a quad mil-stator 1913 rail free-floating handguard. Notice that we have Manta rail protector covers on here. These come with the standard ladder protectors. However, I prefer the Manta rail protectors because they actually protect your hand from heat. They don't, unlike the regular ladder covers, they may protect the overall profile of the rails for damage. They don't really do a lot for heat. This does everything. Also, notice we have two QD point detachment sockets on the front of the handguards on both sides. This pistol actually uses an external piston or short-stroke tappet piston instead of a direct gas system. There are several reasons why the short-barrel gas system works much better with a short-stroke piston than anything else. First of all, the actual cartridge, when it fires in such a short barrel, the propellant does not burn up completely. So basically, in a direct gas system, you're not only introducing hot gases into the gas tube, you're also introducing a lot of unburnt propellant that will find its way back into the bolt carrier group. Also, you have the time pressure curve itself. The time pressure curve on an M855 ball round is right towards the gas port on a 20-inch barrel. So you have not yet reached your high peak pressures. However, with the short-stroke tappet piston, you are not getting any of those unburnt propellants back up into the bolt carrier group itself. And also, with a much larger gas port, you're confining all of your debris to this area up in here, and it blows back the bolt carrier much more reliably with less fouling. The system is quite easy and quite simple. There's actually a four-position gas valve, which is actuated by pushing inward on the plunger on the side, and then rotating one, two, three, four, then we remove. Take a look at the bolt carrier itself as well. Shown here is the actual operating mechanism of the SIG 516 pistol. As you can see here, you have your actual gas plug itself. You can see the three vents on here as well. This is the operating rod, which consists of the operating rod, guide, spring, and the actual piston itself. The bolt carrier is a one-piece bolt carrier where it has an actual impact area instead of a separate key. It's all one piece. A very simple, very robust system. Looking at the lower receiver, there's one more thing that's very notable. You notice right here there's a spring-loaded plunger. What that does is when the upper and lower receiver come together, it keeps it from rattling, which does an excellent job. The 516 pistol is an excellent example of the pistol for for those who want a short barrel but don't want to go through the trouble of getting the actual tax stamps and the licensing. The pistol is an excellent option. Please keep in mind that this must be used as a SIG brace, and once it goes up against your shoulder, you actually are into the realm of a short-barreled rifle, which is actually illegal. So as long as you use as intended, this system is completely legal. It comes with a letter from ATF stating that the SIG brace is legal.
The other day at the office, heading out to the range to check out the SIG 516 pistol, Nemo Arms Omen, and a quarter circle 10 45 caliber cartridge.
The SIG 516 pistol. Returning from the range, my impressions of the 516 pistol are the pistol is very well made, reliable, no malfunctions in the 120 rounds that were fired through it. I'm not particularly a fan of the AR pistols. They're very difficult for me to actually shoot accurately with, unless I'm using them as an SBR, which you can't do with the SIG brace. But for somebody who actually enjoys and likes the feel of the pistol, this is definitely the way to go.